Right, so we're here with Cameron Powers, still musical ambassadors of peace, bringing peace through music and arts and creativity all over the world. And I just wanted to let him leave you with a few words today on inspiration for anyone out there who's thought about traveling the world, studying music and culture, and joining the crazy ones like us who love it so much. And just, you know, there's a lot of propaganda and a lot of stories out there in the media about, you know, what's going on in the world and how scary it is, and it's just really dangerous, and blah, 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 blah. And it's, a lot of it's just, you know, as we know, pretty much bullshit. But, did I say that on film? Yeah.
Bullshit, yeah, pretty much bullshit. Pretty much bullshit.
There's a lot of bullshit out there, a lot of propaganda, and, you know, I hear it all the time about Cuba, he's heard it about a lot of places, he's gone. So I just wanted to ask Cameron, what would you say to an aspiring young person, or older person, who cares what age, that maybe wants to travel the world and bring their gift of music, or go somewhere and learn another culture's music? Would you for a minute say that, you know, they should let any kind of fear be in their way?
The fear factor is something that just dissolves along the path. The boundaries created by modern governments can limit our travel at times. You know, if you have this kind of passport, you may not be welcome in that particular country, and you might have to figure something out, such as I did with Christina when we sang our way across the border into Iraq, just by singing Iraqi songs that dissolved the government prohibitions about letting us in. So, but that's something that evolved down the road. I didn't know how to achieve that ahead of time. What you can do ahead of time, and here's what I'd like to say on the subject, is that if you're going to be a musical ambassador, to some extent you need to like to sing, or you need to like play some instrument, and you like to learn songs, like cover tunes, you know. You may be a songwriter, but to be a musical ambassador, it helps if you want to learn the favorite love songs of that culture that you're interested in. And it can give direction and purpose and even funding for young musicians who want to go down that path, because a musical path is very wide open. You know, basically music expresses all aspects of the human soul, and that's a big project. But, you know, cross-cultural musical connectivity gives a purpose. You use the word peace on planet Earth. There's other ways to define it. Acquiring another soul of your own that speaks a different language and has another array of emotions, you know, is another personal growth-oriented way to define it. Mm-hmm. But the actual possibility, if you're a young musician, of getting in contact with an organization like Musical Ambassadors of Peace.org and presenting what you might want to do that's parallel to what we're talking about here could lead to some training, and it could lead ultimately to some funding for some amazing adventures into other cultures that, you know, there's so many benefits from every angle around doing that.
Not to mention it's really fun too.
Well, that's one of the
That's just a little side. It's a little side benefit.
It's so fun because you can feel your own soul growing and sprouting new wings and new rosebuds along the way. What the building blocks for the whole project look like involve learning another culture's love songs and learning to play and sing their style.
So this is for the Musical Ambassadors of Peace ambassador program that he's speaking about, just so to be clear. So the organization has an ambassador program, so if you want to apply for that program, these are the sort of the elements that
we have. A 3.5 hour video training program which presents the steps one step at a time in 10 chapters.
Yeah, I saw that. That's awesome.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you yourself, who have mastered to such an amazing degree the drumming skills of both West African and Cuban music styles, as well as having, you know, in your pocket, you've got keyboard and guitar skills and off the chart singing skills, you know what I'm talking about. And, you know, young musicians who maybe really want to blossom into a global citizenship could think about learning music from other cultures. And of course, if you're going to really travel and apprentice yourself to master musicians in that culture, you're going to need to do some language work too. And you discover that it's not so hard, because when you start learning the song lyrics in another language, you already have this language spilling out of your tongue. You're already speaking that language, and all you have to do is figure out what you're saying when you're singing that song.
Right.
And, you know, sitting in a coffee shop with some grammar books and dictionaries,
yes,
isn't going to hurt,
you know. Right.
So those are the building blocks: the music, the language, and above all, the desire to go out there and flirt with the world.
Aww. Yay. Well, yeah. I'm going to keep flirting with Cameron. Mm-hmm. Bye. We're going to go.
Okay.
Musical Mission, Musical Ambassadors of Peace.org for Cameron Powers, or for his life coaching work, CameronPowers.com.
Yeah.
All right. And this is Cherie Shanti saying ciao for now. We'll have more later. Mwah.
Bye.